is Adam Oakes. We're in Chiara Manzini's laboratory at George Washington University. This lab studies neurodevelopmental disorders, so we're looking at the diseases of intellectual disability and autism spectrum disorder. I grew up in Maryland, in Anne Arundel County. My father is a microbiologist, and my mother was an obstetrician gynecologist. I think I've definitely picked up on their enthusiasm for those fields in terms of my own trajectory. After I finished my undergrad studies, I had a background at that point in cell biology, and then I was looking for graduate programs, and I wanted an opportunity where I could explore a lot of different things, and I did my first rotation in a neuroscience laboratory that studied Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's disease, and the intersection of those really challenging disease problems with very interesting biological questions about how the brain works, how our minds develop from this huge collection of cells. That was sort of where things really got moving for me in terms of my personal interests. Autism is a disorder of social communication and the ability to control repetitive or restricted behaviors or interests. The families that are affected need a tremendous amount of assistance, and the children need ongoing support. Even very high-functioning autistic children will need lifelong support to be able to function normally. Hey, Mark, how's it going? When I get in the morning, one of the first things I like to do is working on the microscope. We have a lot of image-based experiments that we're working on where we're trying to describe the morphology of neurons either in the brain or in culture. Trying to find a nice looking neuron that we can see clearly the uptake of transferrin when a cell is pulling in materials from outside of itself and taking them up into the interior of the cell. So all of that image, I generate a huge pile of images, and then they also need to be analyzed. So a big part of my day is also image analysis, where we're using software to describe the shape and size and location of these different structures within the cells. Can you switch to just the red channel for me for a second? Okay, so it's interesting. This cell had some uptake, but not a whole lot. You can see the cells around it were really pulling in a lot more. When we see these images and we know that the experiments are working and we know that we're getting good data, it's really satisfying because we're going to be able to answer the questions that we're asking about how these neurons function normally, and then also how their functions are disrupted in the disease model that we're studying. Every day is different. Every day is a challenge. The work that we do is asking and answering very interesting questions and getting at cutting edge things that we don't understand. There's the brain, how it works, how it functions is a very mysterious thing. It's considered to be one of the most complicated structures in all of the universe. The number of potential variables there is so high, and the challenge of trying to figure out how even one small piece of that works is very, very exciting. It's a very exciting opportunity to be part of. Yeah, I come in every day and I have a long list of challenging things to do, and it's a fun way to work. And I depend on the help of my colleagues in the lab to be effective. There's a lot of division of labor that has to happen. It's definitely a team effort. I need to make sure that we can get good images. And you don't have microscope time today, but later in the week. Is that right?
Thursday.
We hope that we can extend that information to describe how disorders like intellectual disability and autism develop in general. By understanding more about the biology of those disorders, we can move towards treatments and therapies that can potentially really help people. And meeting that challenge in the next decade, two decades, is going to require more manpower, more talent, more energy, more enthusiasm from more people to make it happen. If you work hard, things are going to work out for you. I really believe that. And so stay focused, keep working, keep trying to learn and develop and grow and build all of that on a base of hard work.